हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज हम इस वीडियो में बात करेंगे अबाउट द पर्ट। पर्ट इज़ प्रोजेक्ट इवैल्यूएशन एंड रिव्यू टेक्निक। इन दिस वी कंसिडर थ्री टाइम पीरियड्स: ऑप्टिमिस्टिक टाइम, मोस्ट लाइकली टाइम एंड पेसिमिस्टिक टाइम। ऑप्टिमिस्टिक टाइम इज़ द मिनिमम टाइम एन एक्टिविटी इज़ एक्सपेक्टेड टू टेक इफ एवरीथिंग गोज पॉजिटिवली। मोस्ट लाइकली टाइम इज़ द जनरल टाइम विच इज़ रिक्वायर्ड बाई एवरी एक्टिविटी टू कम्प्लीट। एंड पेसिमिस्टिक टाइम इज़ द लाइक इन केस ऑफ एनी अनफेवरेबल कंडीशन वॉट विल बी द मैक्सिमम टाइम दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटी इज गोइंग टू टेक। सो वेन एवर वी विल बी डीलिंग विद द पर्ट प्रॉब्लम्स, वी विल हैव थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ टाइम पीरियड: ऑप्टिमिस्टिक टाइम, मोस्ट लाइकली टाइम एंड पेसिमिस्टिक टाइम। And the formula to calculate the expected time period is optimistic time plus 4 into most likely time plus pessimistic time divided by 6. So when in the problem you will be given these three types of time periods, you need to calculate the expected time by using this formula. So always remember this formula. Right, now when we are dealing with the PERT problems, they are always following the normal distribution curve. Fine, over here we have optimistic time and this is the pessimistic time and this is the most likely time, and we all know that area falling under the curve on both the sides is the 50% area, right? So you need to remember this. We will be considering this in solving the problems. And one thing more we will be calculating is the variance. We denote variance by sigma square and formula is Tp minus To divided by 6 whole square. Fine. Standard deviation is under root of variance. And the formula for calculating the probability is Z is equals to scheduled time period minus expected time period divided by sigma. This sigma and this TE, this will be for the critical path. We will be considering this for the critical path values. And then we will be obtaining the value of the Z from normal distribution table. Fine. So let's understand this with the help of an example. Now we have this question with us that we have these activities 1 to 2, 1 to 3. These are the, how many activities we have? 8 activities are there. And for every activity we are given the optimistic time, most likely and pessimistic time. Fine. So we will be calculating the expected time period by using the this formula we will be using it: To plus 4tm plus tp divided by 6. So this will be 4tm, 4 into 4 16, 16 plus 7 23, 23 plus 1 24, 24 divided by 6 is 4. Then 4 into 10 40, 40 and 10 55, this is 60, this will be 10. Then 4 into 3, 12, 12 plus 3, 15, 15, 3, 18, 18 divided by 6 is 3. Then 4 into 4, 16, 16, 7, 23, 4, 24 divided by 6 is 4. Then 15 into 4 is 60, this is 86, this is 96, and 96 divided by 6 is 16. Then 4 into 4, 16, 16, 6, 22, 22, 24 and 4. This will be 4 into 5, 20, 25, 30, 30 divided by 6 is 5, and 4 into 5, 20, 28, 30, 30 divided by 6 is 5. Now we have calculated the expected time periods. Fine. Now the next thing is we need to draw the activity diagram or the network diagram. So according to this we have, and what we have to do, we have to find out the network diagram, we have to find out the expected project completion time, and we are asked what is the probability that the project will complete in 41 days. Fine. So let's understand this from 1 to 2. The activity diagram will be, we have 1, this will be 2, and this will be 3. Then we have 2 to 4 and 2 to 6. 2 to 4, 2 to 6. Then we have 3 to 4, 3 to 5. Then we have 4 to 5. Then we have 5 to 6. right? So this is our activity diagram, and 1 to 2 expected time period is 4, and 1 to 3 expected time period is 10, 2 to 4 it is 3, then 2 to 6 it is 4, 3 to 4 it is 16, 3 to 5 it is 4, 4 to 5 it is 5, and 5 to 6 it is 5. Fine. Now to find out the critical path, we have how many alternate paths? This 6 is the last activity. We have 1, 2, 6. We have 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. We have 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 1, 3, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 6 path length is 4, 4, 8. Then 4, 3, 7, 12, 5, 17. Then 10, 26, 31, 36. And this one is 10, 14, 19. So this is our critical path. This is the maximum time period, and this will be like this. This is my critical path. Fine. Now after that, they are asking us the expected project completion time. This is the expected project completion time, 36. Fine. Next, they are asking us is what is the probability that it will complete in 41 days. Now to calculate this thing, what we are going to do, we will be calculating the variance of the critical path. Right. So let's first of all write down the critical path activities. That is 1, 2, 3. We have critical path activities 1, 2, 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, and we have 5 to 6. And for these critical activities, we will be writing the pessimistic time and we will be writing the optimistic time. Now, if we refer the previous table, for 1, 2, 3, the pessimistic time is 15 and the optimistic time is 5. So, I will write here. Then, 3 to 4, pessimistic time is 26 and optimistic time is 10. 4 to 5, it is 5. It is 5. Then, 5 to 6, it is 8 and 2. Now we will be calculating the variance of the critical path, which says TP minus TO divided by 6 whole square. So TP minus TO, 15 minus 5, 10. 10 by 6 is 5 by 3. It is 25 by 9. This is 16. 16 by 6 is 16 by 6 is 8 by 3, and this will be 64 by 9. Then 5 minus 5, 0. 8 minus 2, 6, 1. Right? So if I calculate this in decimals, so this will be 9 2s are 18, 7, 70. 9 8s are 72. 9 7s are 63. 7, 63, 7, 7. And this will be 64 divided by 9. So this will be something like 9545, 9654, 97 7 8 63. So this will be 7.11. So the total will be 9.88. This will be 10.88, right? 10.88. Now what we will be doing is, this is the sigma square, and then what we have to do is we need to find out the Z value, which says TS minus TE divided by sigma. Now they are asking us that what is the probability that it will complete in 41 days. So your scheduled time period is 41 days and your expected time is the critical path time, which is 36. सो 3041 डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस 36 डिवाइडेड बाय अंडर रूट ऑफ 10.88, राइट. सो नाउ व्हेन वी विल बी हैविंग दिस, वी विल बी गेटिंग सम जेड वैल्यू, दैट इज 5 डिवाइडेड बाय अंडर रूट ऑफ 10.88, फाइन. सो फॉर दिस 10.88 अंडर रूट, फाइन. सो लेट सपोज दिस वैल्यू कम्स x, फाइन. नाउ इन द नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कर्व टेबल इन एवरी एट द बैक ऑन बैक ऑफ द एवरी बुक वी हैव नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन टेबल वी हैव. सो वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू ओवर हेयर, वी आर मैंशन सम वैल्यू 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 एंड सो ऑन ओवर हेयर ऑल्सो. And for the corresponding these values, we need to check the value over here. And whatever will be the x value, I don't have calculator right now. But when you will be calculating this value and you will be checking it in the normal distribution table, you will be getting the value as 0.4345. Right? And I will be uploading one PPT as a video also. You can check the values from there also. Right? That when we will be solving this, for this particular value in the normal distribution table, the value will be 0.4345. Fine. Now what to do is, to calculate probability, I mentioned in the previous over here that area on every side is 50%. So what you need to do is, you need to add 0.5 plus 0.4345. I again repeat, from where I have taken this 0.5, from the area under the normal distribution curve, that is 50%. 50% means 0.5. So I have added 0.5 plus 0.4345. Had this value been negative, if it was minus 0.4345, then what would I have done? 0.5 minus 0.4345. But the value is positive, so this will become 0.9345. And I can say that the probability of completing the project within 41 days is 93.45%. Right, so this is how we solve the PERT questions with the probability values. And I am from here, I am really sorry, I don't have a right now calculator, but you can calculate the value of this by using the calculator. And when you will be referring this value in the normal distribution table, you will be getting this value, right? Now in exams, you will be provided with these Z values in the table in the question itself. So no need to worry about that. Fine. So this is all about the PERT method in which we calculate the probabilities of the completion of the projects, right? If you like the video, then please do share this video, subscribe to the channel Operations Point for more videos. And if you have any doubts or you want a video on any other topic, you can mention it in the comment section. Thank you.